Okay, welcome back for another MAX BMW video. Gonna be doing a valve clearance check and adjustment on a 2008. All right, so we're gonna start by pulling out the coil stick here. There is a special tool for it, which we'll show you in a second. Okay, now on these edges of the coil stick, you have to be careful when you put the coil tool on there so that they don't break off. The coil sticks can be stuck in there, so they do come off pretty easy. And here I'm showing you the two different styles of the same tool. One is just bigger than the other. The one on my left hand, you could keep underneath your seat in your toolkit if you like. So make sure you put it on securely. And make sure you got a good hold of it so that this way it doesn't break off, and when the coil stick does come out, it doesn't fly out. Alright, so we're going to clean out the hole for the spark plug just to get any dirt out of it. Alright, now we're using another special tool for the spark plug. All these tools you can get here at the dealership if you'd like. Now this bike is getting a full service, so we just like to look at the plugs just to see how the bike is running. But in the case of this particular repair, we're going to be putting new plugs in at the end. Alright, now on this next step, you're going to need like a little drain pan or some shop towels and brake clean. We're going to be removing the valve cover. Uses a T40. And when you pull off the valve cover, it will spill out some oil. With this bike having the crash bars, it's going to make a little bit of a mess, but nothing that we can't handle. And sometimes you could use a rubber mallet. Just give it a light tap because it gets stuck on there. And I emphasize rubber mallet. Now when you are checking your valves, you have to make sure that your engine is cold. So the BMW spec is no more than 95 degrees Fahrenheit. And here I'm just pulling out the inner gasket. You don't want to forget that in there. We're going to replace those with new ones. Okay, so now on this one, you can see where the top of the coil stick has got a little bit of damage. We could still put the tool on it, but this is just what you're trying to avoid. And if you do have it, you just have to be careful. when pulling it out. Again, we're going to blow it out with some compressed air. You can see a lot of dirt came out of this side. Again, we're just repeating the process on this side. Again, just drain pan and a rubber mallet. And you always want to replace these gaskets, especially the inner ones. The inner one takes the shape of the oil passages, so if you reuse them, chances are they're going to leak. Okay, I have the bike in fifth gear, and I'm just bumping the wheel to find the top dead center of the engine. I'm using an aluminum rod here. I put some tape on it just so you could see how we're bringing the piston to the top. Now both sides of the engine will go to the top dead center. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to look to see which side is on valve overlap and which side is at top dead center with no pressure on the valves. And that's what I'm going to be doing right here. I'm going to be grabbing the rockers and seeing if they move freely. Now you're going to take the top dead center pin, another special tool by BMW, and you're going to insert it into the back of the motor. Okay, Carrie's going to show you exactly where it needs to go. There's a hole right next on top of the transmission. So you're going to slide the tool in, and you may have to bump the rear wheel forward or backward just till it finds the hole. And you'll know you're in when the tool is right next to that cutout. Alright, so over here I'm going to show you that portion of the rocker arm. I can't move it because it's on valve overlap, and you can see how the springs have some compression on there. Right now, before you start changing valve clearances or even checking them, you should always check your rocker arm end play first. The rocker arm end play spec is 0.05 millimeter to 0.40 millimeter. Alright, now that's the 0.05. The 0.40 wouldn't fit, which is good. The 0.05 fits, so we have plenty of clearance. Where I'm at right now is the intake side, because of the intake throttle body. You're going to need two feeler gauges at 0.15 millimeters. And when you adjust them, you're going to have both of them in there at the same time. You want to feel just a slight drag. And here I'm just using a 3 millimeter Allen and a 10 millimeter wrench for the lock nut. Just going to tighten that top one a little bit. Okay, so now we're going to move on to the exhaust side, and that's going to be 0.30 millimeters. And once again, you're going to use two feeler gauges. Now, when you're checking the exhaust side, I find you have to make sure that the feeler gauges stay perpendicular to the area that you're checking the clearance for. Like on the bottom one, if you pull it towards you a little bit, you'll feel some resistance, but it's just because you're pulling it towards you. So just make sure that they're in there nice and straight. And the increments that you're turning the 3 millimeter Allen screw is very little. So sometimes you may have to do it a couple of times. And also take into consideration that when you tighten the lock nut, it will pull up on the threads of the Allen screw, which will change the clearance. Okay, here we're going to lock down the adjuster nuts to 8 newton meters. You're going to use a little crow's foot at a 90 degree angle on your torque wrench. And make sure you hold the 3 millimeter Allen screw. All right, now once you're all done torquing down the nuts, you want to recheck the clearances again, because like I said, they can change. That side's good. I can already tell you that this side is good too. Okay, so now at this point, you're going to come around to the other side of the bike, and you're going to remove the top dead center tool. You don't want to forget that in there. And you're going to turn the motor over and repeat the process, but this time on the right side. Okay, now we're going to be using new gaskets. Now comes the fun part, some cleaning. I always like the cleaning. Make sure you get the inside of the valve cover, especially on the bottom part, because sometimes oil will want to drip out on you. And obviously when you're all done and done your test ride, the last thing you want to find is oil at the valve covers. Install a new inner gasket. Now make sure that's sitting on there flush, because it can come off and get wonky inside. So the gasket could only go on one way, which you'll obviously see through the tabs. Okay, I like to start the screws in by hand because you can cross-thread them. We're going to be torquing these down to 10 newton meters. And obviously, always keep a hand on the valve cover. It can fall off. Alright, so for the sake of time, not to bore you guys, I decided to just put on the last three with my gun. Now I have it set to one of the lower settings, and it's got the clutch on there, so if there's a problem, it will stop. And when you tighten them, use a diagonal pattern. Okay, so we got a new spark plug. Always get those threaded in by hand first. And then we're going to be torquing that down to 20 newton meters. using the blue shop towels because they don't leave little pieces of lint. They're pretty strong. Make sure you push in that coil stick all the way. And when you hook it up, the little rubber weatherproof gasket, you want to make sure it doesn't get flipped over. Okay, so we're pretty much wrapped up here. Next thing is a road test and check for leaks. And if you have any questions, you know where to find us.